Hey guys, welcome to another episode of Jake Makes. About this time last year, some random guy on YouTube, whose name was Jake, was challenged to build a PVC slingshot rifle, not unsimilar to that one, by another dude whose name was something like Rebecca. If you're still subscribed and watching my videos, let me know. Anyway, he made this slingshot rifle, and he made like four really long videos on it. Just so stupid. But it actually never really worked that well at all. And he's kind of been feeling bad about it ever since. So it's a new year, new opportunities, new chances to do a heck of a lot of a better job than he did last year. So the random Jake on YouTube is going to make the PVC slingshot rifle using only basic tools which you have at home. Shall we begin? First things first, I want to go over what I like about this slingshot rifle and what I hate about this slingshot rifle. There's not much I like about it, so we'll get those out of the way first. It looks positively awesome. First things first. The aesthetic you get just looking at it, oh, such good vibes. Because it's all about vibes, right? YouTube 2019, it's all about the vibe. Besides just looking really cool, I think the trigger, I really like this trigger. It just works. Other than that, I pretty much hate it. It is way too long. I'm 6'2". This comes up to my chest, so yeah. It's ridiculous. It's too heavy, it's too large, it's too overbuilt, it's too complicated, it is extremely inaccurate. You can watch the testing video. My theory on why it's so inaccurate is because of the way I attach the bands. They're not fixed in the same exact spot, so every time you fire it, they move and twist a little because they're just looped around like this. Besides the fact that it looks absolutely beautiful and that the trigger works well, I pretty much hate the whole thing. So then, version 2.0. Why do they always go like .0 on the end of something? It's not just version 2 or version 3. No, it's version 2.0. How about version 1.1? It sounds cooler, I know. So my main goal for this second one is it's going to be much, much simpler, take a lot less time to make. It probably isn't going to look as pretty, but as long as it functions, I don't really care. Design. Alright, before we start cutting into our PVC, I want to find out how long I'm going to need to cut it. So I've got a good length for a rifle right here. This is the, I don't actually have a video on this one. This is like my hairspray pistol, but a rifle version. Let's see how long this is. 36 plus 6, 42. Okay, so about 40 inches long, going to be a good overall length. So parts, you're going to need about 40 inches of 3/4 inch diameter PVC and two 3/4 inch T-couplings, just straight, no threads, nothing. Then you're gonna need some leather, you're gonna need some wood, you're gonna need some screws, you're gonna need some slingshot rubber, and some paint to make it schmancy. That should be it. What happened to my real tape measure? This is gonna be annoying. I need a real tape measure. Where'd that thing go? All my good tape measures have disappeared. I don't know where they went. I'm gonna cut it a couple inches long, just in case. So, 42 inches. I can trim it down later on if I see that it's necessary, of course, so. Garbage. Ooh. Come on! Who took my saw? This is the problem with having siblings. Whoops. Oh. Okay, now we've got it cut. We're gonna need a mark where we want to bend down the handle and stock section. So, I'm just gonna stick it up on my shoulder like this, hold it out where I would want it to be, and figure out where it would feel comfortable. So about right here is where my hand naturally wants to rest. This, then, should be where my handle grip is. So I'm just gonna go ahead and mark that. Right there. Very scientific, isn't it? We now have our two places to heat and bend the PVC. Now I'm gonna heat form the PVC. I'm gonna use a heat gun. Those of you who don't have a heat gun, don't freak out. Your stovetop in the kitchen will actually work just as well for this. But if you're gonna do a lot of heat forming, I would suggest buying a heat gun. Really handy to have if you do this kind of thing a lot. Awesome. All right, let's go ahead and attach the stock. What's gonna be the butt stock part. Should I add more? Yeah, I will. All right, now to strengthen these T-fittings, which is where the stress is going to be, I'm gonna double up the inner walls. Alright, I went to the store and picked up a couple of these eye bolts. These are going to be the attachment points for the bands. I'm going to attach them right here through the PVC. I just decided to buy some bolts instead of trying to make them out of wood or PVC or something. It'd just be too complicated. This will be a lot easier, simpler, easier for everyone to do, whatnot. Gonna go ahead and mark the holes. Try to make sure they're right in the center. Okay, I'll drill those out. Go ahead and stick one of the nuts on all the way up first. Then, go ahead and screw this down through the pipe. Now tighten that down. All right. Yeah. Go ahead and stick the front part on now. Wow, that is cute. Just some added security and protection to keep this piece onto this piece so this piece doesn't fly back in my face. Safety first, you know what I mean? All right, so here's how the trigger is going to work. Let me erase all this first. Okay, so we're going to have a block of wood right up here on the top. That block is gonna be screwed down to the pipe, and the pouch with the projectile in it, say we have the projectile right here, and the pouch is gonna sit here. Okay, so it just sits right in there. Then we have a dowel rod running through holes drilled in the pipe here that pushes up on this. Then we have a lever right here. You pull up on the lever, it pushes the dowel upwards, which dislodges the pouch over the top of the wood that's holding it in place, and it fires. Fairly straightforward. Hopefully this makes some sense. Got me a piece of plywood. Using plywood because it's strong. Let's say about right there. And here. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Now let's carefully mark out on here where our screws are gonna go. One there, one there, one there. I only have one bolt, so I'm going to use that to make sure it's extra secure. Then I'm gonna use a couple of screws. Make sure it's in place correctly. Couldn't have planned that any better, could I? Good grief.
Too small, too large. How does that work? Too small. Too large. I must have lost the right one.
Just use this ridiculous thing. Oh, and guess what? I have to cut this off with a hacksaw because I'm doing this with simple tools. For the record, I think an angle grinder also counts as a simple tool that everyone should own. If you don't own one, go buy one. They're 15 bucks at Harbor Freight. It's cheap, yeah, but it works. And you need it. Trust me. Okay, now I have to kind of figure out. Say the pouching ball is going to sit right about there, so we want it to push directly up on it. Now we need to try very carefully to make sure this is straight. All right. You know, there are few things less maddening than watching a YouTube video by your favorite YouTuber, and you're at this really great, kind of intense part, you know, the music is building, the project is nearing completion, everything is great, everything's perfect, and then suddenly the screen goes black, and in this really lame font, it says, "Sorry, but I accidentally deleted the footage of me doing this." You know how that happens in a lot of videos? Boy, we are in business. Safety is a priority somewhere. Here goes nothing. All right. Ready, set, go. Shot number two. Oh yeah. Oh man. Awesome. Now I just gotta paint it and we'll be done. And with that, we are done. I would like to wrap the handle with something, but I'm all out of electrical tape, and I don't think I have any duct tape, and I don't want to sit and wrap it in paracord because that would take too long, so. Before we test it, I just want to remind you that if you want updates on my projects before they come out, as well as behind the scenes and other stuff that I'm up to, go to the community page button thing on my channel, and I'm posting stuff, like, often. And you need to be there to see. And ring the bell, so you get notified whenever I post another amazing video. Now let's test it. I I don't really want to do much of a montage for this one because, I don't know, it's super simple and it doesn't even look that cool. But I do want to take a moment to just revel in the beauty and glory of this simple trigger. I mean, it's just beautiful and glorious to behold. All right, let's test it. So much better than last time. Let's see if I can shoot through a milk jug filled with water. Oh!
It did!
I did not see that coming. Let's hit it again. I did not expect that at all. That was sweet! I think I'm gonna have to call it here. This is the best slingshot rifle on YouTube as of right now. In terms of how easy it was to make, the price it'll cost to make, and how well it performs, and what tools you need to make it. This is the best slingshot rifle on YouTube right now. This thing costs literally next to nothing, counting in like cost of the PVC, a couple of fittings which were like 50 cents each, some screws, the eye bolts which were like another 80 cents, like $5 all in, nothing, like dirt cheap. And it works so much better than last time, golly. All right guys, that's about all for today. Thanks so much for watching, I really do appreciate it. Be sure to hit subscribe and ring the bell so you don't miss any of my future uploads. I build stuff like this, like almost every single week. Go now and get off YouTube, get off your behind, and go build something awesome. You have no excuse if you don't, like literally no excuse, I just told you. See you next week, Jake out.